Hi guys, greetings from Belgium and thanks for watching my YouTube channel. Today I'd like to present a bit of a different video from what I normally post on YouTube. I'd like to introduce you to my little harp family here next to me. There's a lot of people asking me questions about what's different about the different types of harps, how do they sound, so I thought I would share my experience in this video. I've got 10 different harps, as you can see in the background, small ones, big ones. Most of them are Celtic harps, one of them is a pedal harp. The reason I'm collecting them is since I fell in love with the instrument, I can't seem to get enough of them. They're all different, they all have their pros and cons, which I'm going to take you through, but I love all of them for different reasons. So I'm going to explain one by one what's cool about them. I'll play a little piece that I composed so you can get a sound comparison across the different instruments. So let's start. So here is what my little family looks like. The majority are Celtic harps, except for this lyre here. The big one over there is actually a pedal harp that's more suitable for classical music. But the rest are all Celtic harp types of instruments. As you can see, every harp has its own tuning key, which is a bit of a mess. It's a shame there's no universal format for tuning keys, because I wish I could use the same device to tune my harps. And if you lose one, it's a bit of a hassle to get the right size of tuning key. But that's the way it is. So as you can see, I've ranked my harps from the smallest one with the fewest number of strings up to the biggest one with the highest number of strings. So let me start with the smallest one on the left. So my first harp here is a cheap Pakistan-made little baby harp with just 10 strings. It's very small. It costs just about 40 euro. Most professional harpists are absolutely horrified when they hear about instruments made in Pakistan, because they have this reputation of being cheap and of very poor quality. So to be fair, those are not the best instruments of the range. Their main benefit is their low cost. So this one costs just about 40 euro on Amazon in Germany. Now, I find it a really nice introductory instrument for little children. It's cheap enough so that you're not afraid of anybody dropping it and breaking it. The sound quality is not that bad. Of course, with that range of strings, it's a bit limited in terms of what repertoire you can play with 10 strings. As a rule, the higher the number of strings, the broader the repertoire you can play. But as a fun instrument to raise children's curiosity with music and with the instrument, I would say it's really cool. I've tuned this little harp in G major. As you can hear, the sound is not too bad. I've been storing this harp in a pretty cold storage room recently, and strangely enough, it's been holding the tune pretty well, so it's a good surprise. So clearly nowhere near a professional grade instrument, but it's not completely rubbish either. So you just have to have the right expectations when getting an instrument like this. It's fun to play. It's better than a toy. It's a great introduction to the instrument for children or for anyone curious about the harp. It's a low investment. So you won't learn advanced technique with this, but it looks great on a tabletop as an interior decor. So let me play a little piece with it. It's a composition called Medieval Dance, which I've published separately on YouTube. Obviously, with such a low number of strings, you have to adapt what you play to make sure it fits the range of what you have at hand. But it's feasible, so let me show you. Thank you. So again, not a professional grade instrument, a limited range of strings, which limits you in terms of the repertoire you can play, but very nice if you want to get a feel for the instrument, have kids play with it. And actually the string tension is quite good on this one, which means it's a great travel companion if you want to keep your calluses, especially when traveling away from your main harp. You can do a few simple exercises to maintain the string tension on your fingers and then keep those calluses. So that's another usage option for that instrument. By the way, if you like this piece, this is a simplified version of my original composition, but you can find the free sheet music on my website at celticizeme and jazzmeup.com. So now let's move on to the next harp. So this little harp here is pretty similar to the previous one. Same price range, about 40 euro, still from Pakistan. So don't get horrified if you're a professional harpist, I know how it feels. But it has a slightly bigger body than the previous one, so a bigger soundboard, and it's interesting to listen to the difference. So you get a sense of how important your soundboard is in impacting the depth of the sound, the quality of the sound. I'm going to do a small demonstration. So you see this is slightly bigger than the previous one. As you could hear, it has slightly more volume, a different sound quality, but the truth is every harp, even within the same model, same range, has its own voice. So it's really important to try them out. Make sure you choose a harp with the sound you like. Same recommendations for this harp here. Better than a toy, very nice introduction to the instrument, especially for kids. Another important thing, if you're serious about learning the instrument, is the body positioning and how you hold your body to play. Playing with this is very different from playing with a larger instrument. So be careful with that if you're really serious with learning the basic technique of the harp. This is not a substitute to teach you the right body position and technique. Again, the string tension and the distance between the strings is not bad. So a very nice replacement instrument when you travel to keep those calluses. So I wouldn't completely trash those. I really love them, especially for workshops with small kids. They're very delightful. But they're like at the very bottom entry point for learning the harp. So now let's move on to harp number three, which is not really a harp. So technically, I'm not sure I should be including this instrument as part of my harp family, because it's this is a lyre, not a harp. So it's definitely a cousin of the harp, but it's a very different shape. The reason I'm including this to my collection is I've been desperately looking for a portable harp that fits in a hand luggage when traveling by plane. And this was the highest number of strings I could fit in a hand luggage, which is what got me into this instrument. It's much flatter because of the different shape of the soundboard, so more portable, more compact. I love the sound, very clear, it's very light. Price range for this instrument is actually can go from 50 up to 300 euro, depending on the make. But the biggest downside I have with this is the tuning and the lack of color coding for the strings, which is different from the Celtic harps. So on traditional Celtic harps, the C's and F's are all color coded, red for the C's and blue for the F's, and not on lyres. Which is a big hassle when you're trying to find your way through the different notes. So it's a habit change, that's the only downside. I've been thinking of color coding the different pins with nail polish. I'm still considering whether it's worth doing, or I don't want to temper the instrument too much. Apart from that, it's an instrument you could tune using a pentatonic scale. So this particular model I have is very popular actually in therapy and meditation. So the great thing about playing in pentatonic scale is it's easy to improvise and everything sounds nice and goes well together harmonically. So that's the main use for that lyre. I'll still try and play my medieval sounding composition just for comparison purposes. Again, it's not necessarily meant for that, and I'm going to have to juggle a bit with finding the strings. But the sound is very pleasant. Definitely a different resonance and volume. But again, for me, it's a more intimate sort of sound. I really like it for portability when I'm traveling by plane again. Very far from the typical harp, so in terms of technique it requires a lot of adapting and playing around with the body position and hand position. So more for having fun when you're really harp deprived on a trip, or when you just want to relax and play without thinking too much. It's a forgiving instrument. So I just wanted to mention that interesting alternative. Now let's move on to the next instrument. So this harp comes from a store called the Early Music Shop in the UK. It's a very reputable music store. This is called a Gothic harp, although it's only Gothic shaped. It doesn't really produce what we think was the actual Gothic sound. But it looks very pretty. It looks quite small and compact, but sadly it doesn't fit in any of the large suitcases I've got at home. So not a nice travel companion. But for the rest, it has a very interesting sound. I think it sounds great for traditional music. Again, the ergonomics are different from the typical Celtic harps. The string spacing is slightly smaller, so again it's a bit of a different animal, but for that price point, if you're into traditional music, this is a very nice alternative. I'm trying to play my same piece again. Not suitable for long haul flights. Now, having said that, in a car it fits perfectly. It's extremely portable, very convenient instrument, very nice sound quality, very robust. It's a bit heavy though, not ideal for instruments for beginners. It could be a nice complement to your main instrument for gigs because of its portability. This harp has 19 strings, so in terms of strings for your buck, it's really not bad. Lots of qualities. Only downside, again, is a bit heavy to hold. Ergonomics are not representative of the traditional Celtic harps. So not ideal for a starter, but a very decent instrument. Very pleasant to play. Portable in a car, not in a plane. For me, it's a great side instrument. But let's move on to the next harp, which for me is a very good deal for beginner harpists. And it's the Derwent harp, manufactured in the UK. It has a nice little stand with it, optional, but very convenient to hold and store your harp, or even to keep it stable when you play. This one I really love for its design. You can choose from an amazing range of colors, shades, fancy designs to customize your harp. It's very robust, the sound quality is very good, the tension of the strings is good, the spacing of the strings is good, and it only costs around 200 euro. So depending on the options you add, it could be more expensive, especially if you want to add levers that help you add sharps and flats to the strings without using your tuning key, which is extremely helpful when you start playing several pieces of a broad repertoire. So that could like double the price of the instrument. But for a basic version without tuning levers, you have a very decent price that competes with the cheap Pakistani harps with a very competitive sound quality. So less traditional looking than the beautiful carving from the Pakistan made harps, but extremely cute. And this is a very popular instrument with beginner harpists. It's a low risk investment and very robust, durable, very nice sound quality. And I'm very impressed with this. Let me play you the same tune on this instrument. Students who are very happy with this. This is an excellent, affordable, convenient harp for beginners. Easy to store at home, it doesn't take too much space. Lots of great options if you can afford them. Easy to customize, excellent service from its UK manufacturer. I can only recommend it. It has a 20 string range, which is very good for beginners, lots of possibilities. 20 strings is definitely enough for the first few years as a beginner. Then you can decide to upgrade to a more expensive harp and keep it as a side instrument for gigs again. Very portable in a car, not necessarily on a plane. Really, really love this instrument. Harp in line is a completely different animal. This comes from Scotland, from a very reputable harp manufacturer called Ardival. This is their Rose Markey harp. Very unique sound. The shape and the design were inspired by primitive Pictish harps. This is much more expensive than everything else we've seen so far, in the range of 1,000 euro. This is much more expensive than everything we've seen so far, in the range of 1,000 euro. Beautiful craftsmanship. Very pure sound, perfect for Celtic music, very portable. And this fits in my big Samsonite suitcase when I travel abroad on a plane, finally. So it goes with me almost everywhere. So when I'm on a big trip overseas, this would typically come with me. And I added my own strap to hold it more easily. So let's give it a try. Thank you. So I love its sound, very bright, especially considering the very thin soundboard. I love the wood they're using as well. It's like super high quality. It's a lovely instrument. It's 19 strings again, but definitely if you're passionate with Celtic traditional music and if you want portability, this is top. Really like it. I got a chance to carry it to the beach on the other side of the world. It's amazing, and its sound is absolutely delightful. So that's for the little Ardival Lux Marquis. This harp here is actually the first harp I ever purchased, and lo and behold, it's made in Pakistan. It cost between 200 and 300 euro. Very good deal for the size and the number of strings, but again, not a great substitute for a study instrument. Biggest downsides are the tension of the strings. It's a bit too low to learn proper finger technique, and so sadly the levers just don't work. Lifting a lever is supposed to raise a note by half a tone, and those levers are simply not adjusted. So it would take some do-it-yourself work to readjust them and make sure they get the right tuning, which is a lot of hassle. I've never bothered doing that with this harp. I'm not much of a DIY person, and if I want to get sharps and flats, what I do is I just fiddle around with the tuning key, which is less flexible, but it does the trick in many cases. So again, this sort of instrument is a blasphemy for most professional harpists, but I have to admit that I've really enjoyed playing on this harp as a beginner. So to be clear, you won't develop a strong technique on this because the string tension is really low. So it doesn't help you get the right sensation for playing. This is not great to get used to the right sensation of placing your fingers with the right tension, but it looks and sounds beautiful. And in my early days as a harpist, I even performed in public with this instrument. It sounds very mellow. It definitely produced a very decent and pleasant sound. So yeah, I have mixed feelings about this harp. I would definitely not trash it. So you always get a sense of guilt and shame in front of other professional harpists when you dig out such a heresy of an instrument. It's in the same range as the beginner baby harps that I was showing before. So great for an introduction, not great for learning the technical basics of harp. Very pleasant to have fun with music. Now this instrument is much more expensive, between 200 and 300 euro. But if all you want is have fun, create music, I say why not? I know I'm going against the mainstream recommendation from most harpists. Would never recommend this. But in some cases, again, I would say why not? Not my top choice for a beginner who's serious about learning the harp. As I said before, the Derwent is an excellent choice for the same price range. So the Derwent definitely outperforms this one. As a summary, it looks very neat, doesn't sound too bad, but not great for learning the technique. Thank you. sound, it's very soft, but it does feel like playing with spaghetti instead of strings. I would actually think this would be a nice instrument to play in harp therapy settings because the sound is very soft and relaxing. Now, you can't use it for all harp therapy techniques because it's very heavy. Probably not be able to give it to patients to hold because it's quite bulky and heavy. But it does have a pleasing sound. So I can definitely relate to every harpist telling you this is not a proper instrument to learn serious technique. But you can have fun with this. It has its flaws, unfortunately, but it looks and sounds nice. So this was the last of the Made in Pakistan series for today. Now we'll move on to a much higher price range. And this is one of my personal favorites because this is a harp from Camac, a French harp manufacturer that is extremely famous and renowned. So this is the Camac Bardic with 27 strings, fully levered. Now we're talking a much higher price range. We're talking close to 1,500 euro. I'm a big addict of the Camac harp sound as a rule. Whatever harp it is from Camac, somehow it has a signature sound that I really enjoy. It's a question of taste. It's very pure, I find, very high craftsmanship. This is an absolutely reliable brand. You can't go wrong with a Camac. So they have an amazing range of Celtic harps. This is a small one, that's why they call it Bardic, which is a reference to the traveling musicians from the past who are carrying it around with them. It's about 10 kilograms, I would say. So yes, you can carry it again in the trunk of your car, not on a plane. It's quite fragile. It's a delicate instrument. And at that price point, you don't want to bang it all over the place and destroy it, unlike the cheapy versions that I just showed. But it's a nice practice instrument for beginners. I think you can adapt a big chunk of the Celtic harp repertoire for that range of strings. You may need to transpose to use the full bass range of that harp. This is the lowest C string. I use it a lot for harp therapy because it has a rich, clear, but not too projective kind of sound. Again, I love the signature Camac type of sound. I think it's very harpistic in my mind. So it's really my instrument of choice for harp therapy. I also give gigs with it. I also love to play in nature with it. I think its sound blends really nicely with natural environments. So here's a little demonstration. Thank you. what number of string is right for you. A lot of pieces can be adapted for fewer strings, like I showed on the super small 10-string baby harps in the beginning. But what you're missing is the richness of the bass. So for me, that's the biggest trade-off when you move to a smaller harp size, missing that bass, which gives some richness and depth to the music. That's a sacrifice you need to make. So back to this little Kamak Bardic. It's a kind of all-in-one alternative for harpists. Decent range of strings, excellent quality, totally reliable manufacturer. You can't go wrong with a Kamak. This is a good compromise in portability, compaction, and quality and versatility. The typical high-quality Celtic harp would cost something like 2,000 euro for 36 strings. If you can't afford that, I think this is an excellent option. I've got a student playing with this as a beginner. He's very happy with it. It's like the yoga PC of harps, you know, those all-in-one tablets plus PC. That's the way I look at it. A very nice alternative, very nice compromise. And now we're going to move up to a much more expensive type of instrument. So this harp here comes from America. It was designed and made by Heartland Harps. It's a very unique model because it's all made of carbon fiber. So this is technically plastic, which has a lot of advantages. It's very light. It's practically indestructible. Doesn't care about temperature, humidity. You can store it in a super hot car trunk without fear of damage. It's the SUV of harps. It can go anywhere. It can resist anything. You just need to be careful of the lever mechanism, but overall, it's a super sturdy harp. And it's a technical prowess. It's not easy to get a rich sound from plastic as opposed to wood. That's why those harps are very expensive. So the entry price point for such a harp would be around $5,000 or $6,000. Now, due to its extreme portability, it's an amazing option for people with health issues who can't handle the weight of a traditional harp. So definitely too big, unfortunately, for hand luggage on a plane, but I wouldn't be afraid to pack it up and check it in, because I know it can resist shock and it will look fine after a long trip on a plane. The sound quality is amazing, especially for the bass. The bass is very rich. This one is the Infinity model from Heartland, and it has 36 strings. So I know the price point is prohibitive. Maybe you can get it secondhand if you live in the US. It's a blessing for anybody with physical ailments to keep playing harp. You can even immerse this instrument in water, or at least play in the rain without fear of damaging anything. So it's really a little gem of a design, and the quality of execution is very impressive. It's really well thought, well designed. There's lots of tiny details, like you've got a retractable foot to adjust the height. Extremely user-friendly. So this is the Rolls-Royce of Celtic harps in terms of convenience, usability, and friendliness to use. Now I'll do a little sound check. Thank you. built-in connection to amplify it electrically. You can even install lights on it. Sounds like a gadget, but in reality, if you ever want to play in a dark location, it's really helpful. You need to see your strings to know what you're doing. So really designed with a great sense of quality and user-friendliness. Amazing harp. And our last candidate for today is a complete different animal. It's not in the Celtic harp family, it's a pedal harp. So meant for classical music, because with all the pedals you can easily do sharps and flats. It has a lot of flexibility when you play. So this is the harp you want to be able to play classical repertoire, because you can play virtually anything on it. Jazz is typically very difficult on a Celtic harp. It's also difficult on pedal harp, but at least it's feasible, because you can manage the tonality changes and note changes with your feet. Requires a completely different set of skills, synchronizing your feet together with your hands and brain. But I just thought I would show how it sounds in comparison. It's actually a small pedal harp with only 44 strings compared to the regular pedal harps that have typically 47. So this smallish concert harp already costs in the $15,000 range, which is a lot, but it has something magical about its sound to justify the price. So let me play you the same piece on this instrument so you can judge. Sound for some reason, but you see all those mechanisms that connect the strings to the pedals in order to play sharps and flats. This is extremely complex and delicate, which is the reason why pedal harps are so expensive. So I hope you found this presentation interesting. In my next video, we will play a little game where I will play all 10 harps I just showed you, and you'll have to guess which one it is just from the sound. And thanks again for watching my channel. If you have any questions on this video, or if you have any suggestions for future videos, don't be shy and post them in the comments. Thanks, bye!